Good morning, PHS. I'm Ben.
And I'm Sam. Today is Tuesday, March 6th, and day number 4 on your schedule. One of the national holidays that fall on today's day is National Cheese Doodle Day.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Minithon is coming up. If you haven't already participated, Minithon is a 12-hour service event filled with fun and games. In order to attend, you must fundraise $30 by March 16th. All money raised will go to Ford Diamond Foundation. This year's event will take place in PHS Gym and Cafeteria on Saturday, March 16th from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. The Google Classroom code is ULR60ZR. We hope to see you there.
Pop out for the talent show Wednesday, March 6th at 7 p.m. in the library. It's free and it will be a good time, I promise.
Hey seniors, the senior yearbook signature page is ready for you. Please stop by the yearbook table during all lunch periods, Monday, March 4th through Thursday, March 7th. If you are a senior option student and leave early, please stop the cafe before you leave. Any questions, contact Ms. Tate.
Attention all Princess Breakfast participants. There will be a mandatory meeting on Tuesday in the auditorium during AP and a second meeting on Friday in room 122. Please see Mrs. Kane or Mrs. Antonello with any questions.
An effort to capture as many students as possible with regards to attendance recovery. We are adjusting our schedule. Attendance recovery session will now be offered in the morning and the afternoon. Any student attending the afternoon session that does not walk home will need to provide their own transportation home.
The schedule is Monday from 7 to 7:30, Tuesday from 2:30 to 3, Wednesday from 7 to 7:30, Thursday from 2:30 to 3, and from Friday from 7 to 7:30.
Join Club Unify to help make inconclusive a reality by taking a pledge to spread the word. Your pledge signifies a stance against hurtful language targeted at individuals with intellectual disabilities.
Together we can create a school where everyone is valued, celebrated, and free from impact of harmful stereotypes. Sign the pledge March 6th during all lunch periods.
It is National Foreign Language Week, March 3rd to 9th. This year's theme is Learning Languages Promotes Friendship. Celebrate your language with a friend this week.
Reminders for the NJGPA 11th grade New Jersey graduation proficiency assessment testing will be March 11th to the 14th. March 11th and 12th is ELA, March 13th and 14th is the math. Testing will begin at 7:38 a.m. Please arrive to school on time. Cell phones are not permitted in testing. Cell phones will be collected in the cell phone holder. If the student does not want their cell phone collected, put it in a locker or leave it at home.
No coats, book bags, drawstring bags, or purses are allowed in the testing site. Please place these items in a locker before testing. Your locker number and combination are listed on the summary page of the parent portal and student portal.
Students need to bring earbuds for the ELA testing. Students should check sound when logging in on NJGPA.
Please bring a book magazine to read for when they are finished the test.
Testing will begin at 7:38. Students should bring items to locker between 7:30 to 7:38.
Attention all juniors and seniors. AP Biology students interested in the pursuing a career in medicine. On Friday, April 26th, Dr. Johnson and his team from St. Luke's Hospital will be conducting a dissection of the human arm. Any students interested required to complete and submit an application by Friday, March 15th to Ms. Persolowski. Applications can be found in room 209 or Google Classroom code TKIB2W3.
Vote for the winning design for this year's Inclusion Week Whiteout T-shirt. Be on the lookout for the Google form to vote in your state learner's email beginning Monday, March 11th, 2024. The form will close at the end of the school day, Wednesday, March 13th.
Finally, let's hand it over to Lenacy with the weather.
Good morning, PHS. I'm Lenacy. Today's weather will be mostly rainy with a high of 57 and a low of 47. Let's hand it back to the anchors.
Today we have Makai with us to share some information about state learner sports. Also, make sure you stay tuned after to watch a special clip.
The This is Makai reporting the State Line of Sports for the day. Open gyms and tryouts for PSS cheerleading are starting in April. Please join our tryout Google Classroom to assess the tryout packet and to receive important messages regarding tryouts. The classroom code is EGNU7AI. Please see Mrs. Shiv in room 216 with any questions. There will be a mandatory meeting for all boys trying out for the boys golf team this spring in room 114. During AP on Wednesday, March 6th, there will be a meeting during AP on Wednesday, March 6th for all Little Liner swim team coaches in room 109. We will be discussing the upcoming season. Congratulations to the following boys swim team members who competed at Meet of Champions this past weekend. Austin Alexa and Nick Berger were the part of the 200 free relay, which went into the weekend ranked 32nd but finished 19th in the state. Nick Berger finished 11th in the state for the 100 free and the 16th in the 50 free. Both Austin and Nick will be going to districts and then onto nationals for their YMC team. That's all for me. Now for the special clip.
And Kareem, who am I here with today?
John Wardo.
All right. First question, what brought you to PHS?
I was born in Powhat, so I've always been born and raised here, and I've been always coming to football and wrestling matches here, and that's pretty much how I've been brought into this.
Why don't you tell us about yourself?
I play football and I wrestle at Peterborough. I'm going to be going to college for most likely wrestling after my senior year here. And I like chocolate.
Okay, what sports do you play here at PHS?
I play football and I wrestle.
Okay. How was the wrestling team?
Went through a lot of adversity throughout the entire season. Our wrestling team was very good. We went undefeated until we went to finals and lost, unfortunately. But as a team, I'm really happy that I was with them for my senior year.
Okay, how do you feel about this season?
Successful, but also was mainly family. We came really close together throughout the entire season, and I wouldn't want to do it with anyone else.
All right. What was your favorite moment this season?
Probably our win over Easton.
Yeah.
That was huge. That was a really big win for all of us.
Okay. How do you feel about the win against Easton?
Amazing. It feels really good to go back-to-back from football and wrestling and win them both. And even win past few years against them in wrestling when we're on a very good streak right now beating Easton in wrestling.
Okay, what is your favorite part of the school?
The people that you come into contact with, the teachers you come into contact with, everyone. Majority of people are just very nice and very welcoming, and that's something that I'll definitely take from being here.
And what are some of your hobbies and interests outside of school?
Can sleeping count as a hobby? I mean, because I try to do as much as I can. But you know, I just watch TV, relax, don't do anything too crazy. If anything, I'll, you know, just kick back, hang out, do whatever I need to do. And I don't have many hobbies. I can build, I mean, if I have Legos to build, I'll build Legos. That's something I can do a lot.
All right, thank you.
That is all we have for you today, Peebers. Thank you for watching today's St. Larry TV show.
Have a fantastic day.